Integral calculus means we have to add a small number of segment. For example, in this one, this is one graph and I need to find out area under this graph. तो क्या करेंगे, इसको small small rectangle में divide करेंगे. जैसे ये divide कर दिया मैंने small small rectangle में, अब सारे rectangle की area add करोगे, so that will be total area. So rather than adding it manually, we use one concept that is called integration. मतलब इसका जो graph है, means इस graph का जो equation है, इस equation को आप integrate कर दो कहाँ से कहाँ तक, 0 to x. तो जब आप इसे इंटीग्रेट करोगे तो एरिया आ जाएगा. ए एप्लीकेशन होता है इंटीग्रेशन का. तो इंटीग्रेशन मतलब क्या होता है कि एडिशन ऑफ वेरी स्मॉल इन्फाइनेटली स्मॉल नंबर ऑफ सेगमेंट्स. देयर इज सम फॉर्मूला फॉर इंटीग्रेशन दैट यू नीड टू बाय हार्ट. सो वंस आई रीड दिस वन सो दैट यू नो व्हाट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट ऑल वेरिएबल्स. इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ साइन एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस कॉस एक्स प्लस सी. दिस सी इज कॉन्स्टेंट. And meaning of this one, this symbol and dx, we are integrating this sin x, nothing else. So integration of sin x, that will be minus cos x plus one constant. Similarly, integration of cos x dx and this symbol means just integration. So integration of cos x sin x plus c, similarly sec square x integration tan x plus c, then cosec square integration minus cot x plus c, so on. Sec x into tan x integration sec x plus c, then cos x x into cot x minus cos x plus c. And this one is most important one, integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus 1 constant. In all integration, just we keep on adding one constant because this integration is called indefinite integration, means limits are not defined. Just we are integrating, but we don't know what should be lower limit and upper limits. So that integration is called indefinite integration. Later on, I'll explain what's an indefinite and definite integration. But in case of indefinite integration, we have to add one constant. So if you see in all formula, hum ek constant ko add karte ja rahe hain. Integration of 1 by x dx, that is ln x plus c. Integration of 1 by x square plus a square, that will be 1 by a. Tan inverse x by a, similarly integration of this one, 1 divided by root a square minus x square dx, that will be sin inverse x by a. So these are formula for integrations. Based on this formula, we'll do some integration. For example, if we have to integrate x, y is equal to x is given and you have to integrate. So if I have to integrate this one, I'll get y is equal to x dx. Now I'll use this formula. Integration of x power n dx, this formula x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. And remember, this formula is only applicable if n is not equal to minus 1. If n is equal to minus 1, aap is formula ko apply nahi kar sakte. To ab is integration mein mujhe is formula ko apply karna hai. If you see, what's a power of x, that is 1. So integration of this one, that will be x power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1, that will be x square by 2. So one more example I'll take, y is equal to x cube. What's the integration of this? Similarly again I'll write integration of this one, integration x cube dx using this formula, x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, I'll get x power 3 plus 1 divided by 3 plus 1 plus 1 constant. So I'll get x power 4 divided by 4 plus 1, 4 plus c. 1 constant will be always there because this integration is called indefinite integration, means limits are not given. Now what is definite and indefinite integration? For example, if we have to integrate t square dt, so if you have to integrate t square dt according to this formula, variable will be t, means formula will be like this, integration t power n dt, that will be t power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, aur ek constant idhar add ho jayega. To ab isko isi ke hisab se integrate karna hai, to kya aayega aapka answer? Isko aap integrate karoge to iska answer aayega इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ टी स्क्वायर डी टी, इसको इंटीग्रेट करना है आपका आएगा टी पावर 2 प्लस 1 डिवाइड बाय 2 प्लस 1 प्लस सी. तो ये क्या आ गया, टी क्यूब बाय 3 प्लस सी. इसको हम बोलते हैं indefinite integration. This is indefinite, means limits are not given. Now, this same function, this same example, I'll give for definite one. For example, this only d square dt I have to integrate. Now, this is indefinite. If I put limit, limit means lower limit 1, upper limit 2, it can be anything. It can be anything, 1, 2, 3, 4, x1, x2, anything. So, lower limit I am putting 1 and upper limit 2. Now, this one become definite integration. Till now, this was indefinite. Now, this become definite integration. So, if I integrate this one, I will get t cube by 3. And what's the upper limit? 2 and lower limit? 1. So, if I put limit in place of t, what's the process to put limit? In place of this t, first I'll write upper limit. With minus sign, I'll write lower limit. It means, in place of this t, I'll write 2. That will be 2 cube by 3. Again, in place of this t, I'll write 1. So, 1 cube divided by 3. So, that will become 8 by 3 minus 1 by 3. So, that becomes 7 by 3. See, we are getting one constant value over here. That's why we say this integration is definite integration. So, this is the difference between definite and indefinite integration. Indefinite means that limits won't be given. So, that's why we add one constant. Definite mein kya hoga? Limits given hoga. Ek aur example deta hun based on this one. You'll get better understanding. For example, let's say you have to integrate cos x from 0 to pi. So, if you have to integrate cos x, you have to integrate cos x from 0 to pi, and if you are integrating cos x dx, what's the answer for this one? Integration of cos x dx, if you see the formula, integration of cos x dx is sin x plus c. Sin x plus c. This is indefinite, but I am putting limit over here, 0 to pi. Now it become definite. So, integration of this one become cos x integration, that becomes sin x, and limit will be 0 to pi. Now, in place of x, I'll write pi. With minus sign in place of x, I'll write 0. It means sin pi minus sin 0. You know, sin pi is 0, sin 0 also 0. So, answer will be 0. So, this is indefinite integration. There are no limits. And this one is called definite integration. Now, based on definite and indefinite integration, I'll do some other questions. Let's say this function is given y is equal to x square plus 2x plus 3. Now, I need to integrate this one. Now, first I'll do indefinite integration. See, if I integrate this one, so I'll get integration y dy left side is equal to integration x square dx plus 2x integration dx plus 3 integration dx. This 2 is constant, so I can take outside. So, integration of this one, I'll get x cube by 3 plus 2x square by 2 plus 3x plus c. I use this formula for this one. Integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So, see, here what's the value of n? 2. So, x power 2 plus 1, that becomes 3, 3 divided by 3. This 2 as it is, I'll take it outside. And integration of x, that will be x power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1. So, that is 2. 3 outside, integration of this dx. Integration of dx means, we can also write, integration of dx means x power 0 dx. Same thing. So, x power 0 dx means x power 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1. So, that's why x. That's why integration of dx is x. Now, we'll do some question based on definite integration. This is indefinite integration. Now, one question based on definite integration I'll show you. Let's say this function is given to you. y is equal to 2x square plus 3x plus 5. 2x square plus 3x plus 5. Now, I have to integrate this function from 3 to 6. It means this become definite integration. So, if I integrate this one from 3 to 6, what I'll get over here? Integration of 2x square dx plus integration of 3x dx plus integration of 5 dx. Now, whatever constant term is there, I'll take it outside, and limits are given. Here limits are given, that limit is that limit is 3 to 6. So here 3 to 6, this is 3 to 6, this is 3 to 6. Now it become indefinite integration. So integration of this one, 2 I'll take outside. Integration of this become x cubed divided by 3 and 3 to 6. Plus 3 I'll take outside. Integration of this one become x square by 2, 3 to 6. Similarly, 5 I take outside. This is x, 3 to 6. Now I'll put upper limit with minus sign, lower limit. So 2, this one is 6 square divided by 3 minus, not 6 cube divided by 3, minus 3 cube divided by 3. This is 3 and this one is what, 6 square divided by 2 minus 3 square divided by 2. This one 5 in place of x, I'll write 6 minus 3. If I calculate this whole thing, I'll get this one will be 181.5. This is indefinite integration. Sorry, this is definite integration. If limits are given, definite. If limits are not given, that is called indefinite integration. Now, I'll explain some application of this integration in physics. What's the use of this integration in physics? For example, we know acceleration is rate of change of velocity. So acceleration we can write dv by dx. That is called rate of change of velocity. Now, if I write this one, dv is equal to e dx. That's fine, just cross multiplication. Now I integrate this. And here acceleration is constant, so I'll take a outside. So integration of dv, that will be equal to a integration dx. Now what's the integration of dv and dx? See, integration of dv we can write v power 0 dv. Again I can use that formula, v power 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1. So what I'll get? V. And what will be integration of dx? Integration of dx similarly, x power